Today, the deputy assistant to the U.S. Secretary of State, Hadi Amr, who is responsible for the Palestinian-Israeli unit in the U.S. State Department, has arrived in Israel, and supposedly he will try to negotiate a ceasefire agreement between the Palestinians and Israel. Whether he succeeds or not, it will be seen. Even though that we know that the U.S. is very supportive of Israel and the U.S. is not an honest broker in this Palestinian-Israeli conflict, but we still hope that this current U.S. administration led by President Biden will be at least semi-neutral to the Palestinian-Israeli conflict, unlike the previous U.S. administration led by President Donald Trump, who was very biased toward Israel in many ways.
As you say, a U.S. representative is coming. Who is coming to meet them? And who can represent the interests of Palestinians in this moment that would actually lead to de-escalation?
Well, still, Palestinian President Mahmoud Abbas is the chairman of the PLO, which recognized Israel. But at the end of the day, the fighting is going on in Gaza. And
with Hamas, right? So
yeah, Hamas is in control of Gaza. But Hamas has very good relationship with the Qataris, with the Turks, with the Egyptians. The U.S. still classify Hamas as a terrorist organization, which would mean that Hadi Amr will not be able to talk directly to Hamas.
Akiva, I want to come to you because obviously the last peace negotiations collapsed. I think this was back in April 2014. In fact, under then Secretary of State John Kerry, how different are things now, especially since Netanyahu, the prime minister, has really been struggling to maintain his power in recent months?
You touched the bottom line of this event, and this is the future of Prime Minister Netanyahu. I believe that we can reach now truce of ceasefire because Netanyahu got what he wanted. And what he wanted is to destroy the possibility and to put an end to this tango between the right, left, and center in Israel.
And for context for people, he was supposed to form a coalition government, has struggled to do so, and is facing corruption charges.
Right. I think that it was very clear to us that Netanyahu wanted to achieve two things. One is to avoid going to jail, which was very imminent. Number two is his strategy was to support Hamas as long as he can stop the peace process.
Akiva Eldar, my final question is, what are you going to be listening for over the next couple of days that will give you a sense of where this is headed?
So surprise, Netanyahu is a warmonger like Trump.
I will be following closely is whether the international community, the U.S., is going to deal with this cancer and not with using aspirin. I don't see any way where the Israelis and the Hamas can reach an agreement as long as the Israeli government is held by the Israeli right-wing parties who don't believe in a two-state solution. And in Gaza, what the Hamas managed to do is to unite the Palestinian communities in Gaza, the West Bank, East Jerusalem, and Israel proper. And this is not going away if we don't deal with it in the roots of this seriously.
Akiva, let me just interrupt here and say, let's agree on one thing here, that the continuation of the Israeli occupation of West Bank, Gaza, and East Jerusalem, which has been going on for more than half a century now, since 1967, and a creeping annexation with settlement expansion on Palestinian territory is the source of the problem. Let's agree that if Israel puts an end to its occupation of Palestinian land and accept international law and UN Security Council resolutions 242 and 338, there is a good possibility for peace. There is a good possibility for security and peace for both Palestinians and Israelis.
I fully agree with you, my friend.
That's Israeli political analyst and journalist Akiva Eldar and Mehemar Abusada, professor of political science at Al-Azhar University in Gaza.
Stop stealing land, stop terrorizing people, and maybe people will stop fighting.
Scientists have found something pretty incredible at the bottom of the Pacific Ocean. Atoms of a rare kind of plutonium.